Me the opportunity to speak in this special discussion of the happening of Ochki cyclone. Sir, firstly, on behalf of our state and our party, we would like to extend our sympathies and concern to all the families who have lost their lives, who have lost their dear ones, who have lost their family members in this unfortunate event. And on behalf of the state of Kerala, we would request the central government that whatever demands have been put forward, irrespective of the parties, irrespective of the places that they come from, that the central government takes complete responsibility and holds up their right in serving justice to the state of Kerala, Lakshadweep, and also Tamil Nadu, sir. Sir, I speak because even I come from a coastal region of Srikakulam, sir, in the state of Andhra Pradesh. And we are totally not new to cyclones, sir. If you take our history also, in the last 5 years, we have had 3 major cyclones. In 2012, we had the Phailin cyclone, sir. 2013-14, we had the Hudud cyclone. And we also had a Laila cyclone in 2013. And recently also in the month of November, we had an early warning of another cyclone, which was missed, but we had a heavy floods in our region, sir. And if you see in our region, in the yearly calendar, sir, there is the month of October, there is the month of December, but there is no November for us. There is only the cyclone month. What comes after October for us is the cyclone month. After, at the end of the October, it brings so much fear in the farmers, in the fishermen community, in the general people, that what cyclone might come, what natural disaster might come. And it is at this time, sir, that we have to think on more bigger terms than rather than just one cyclone at a time. And based on the experiences that we have faced, especially from the Hudud cyclone, which was very, very devastating for the north coastal Andhra Pradesh, especially the state, city of Visakhapatnam, I would like to put forward some suggestions to the central government, sir. Sir, whenever these kind of natural calamities happen in the country, the central government sends their teams to assess the damage. Well, I have to put forward this suggestion, sir, because there has been a very big delay in finding out the extent of the damage that had happened in these places, sir. When the Hudud has happened, the state government, in fact, within a week, they have assessed a primary damage list and they have sent it to the central government, sir, for an approximate 16,000 crores. But the central government sent their own teams. For a period of 1 month, they have been going around the state, going around the affected areas, and they have come up with a different number. We appreciate the fact that the Prime Minister took time in visiting the affected area. It helped us to have a hope and confidence in the people also, sir. But what has to be followed up is that the sufficient amount of compensation also reaches in a justified time, sir. Because, like we say, justice delayed is justice denied. Support delayed is also support denied, sir. If you send any amount of money after 6 months or 1 year to these areas, it doesn't have the same effect, sir, when you have to send it within the week or 2 weeks of its happening, sir. So the central government definitely should keep in mind that whatever support they intend to give to these areas, it has to be sent within an immediate effect, sir. That is one concern that I want to put forward to the central government. And also, sir, there are a lot of central government schemes in terms of building up of infrastructure. There is the housing scheme. There is a special scheme, PMGSY, for building up of the roads, for infrastructure. Sir, whenever an event of such high caliber happens, the central government should associate some of the schemes to these areas, sir. The reason why I say this is, when the Hudud happened, sir, in my very own constituency, there are some areas where the roads have been completely devastated. Till now, I have not been able to lay down new roads in that area, sir. We have sent the sufficient, all the proposals, we have written all the proposals, everything we have done with the state government, with the central government, but sufficient support has still not been given. If they could have attached those areas with one of the already existing schemes, then we could have had a better chance of filling up the needs of that area, sir. So the central government scheme should be given a priority in these kind of affected areas. When that is done, sir, the development, the infrastructure loss that has happened in these areas can be covered up in a better way, sir. And first of all, we have to definitely, in times of this, we have to remember the farmers and the fishermen community. Those are the first ones to be affected, sir. When it comes to the farmers, especially in our area of Vishakhapatnam, Vijayanagaram and Srikakulam, sir, it's a completely rural area. There are a lot of farmers involved, especially when you see that they're all paddy growers. Right at the November is the time of the harvest for all these farmers, sir. Right when the crop is ready to be harvested, when it comes to the hand, it has been destroyed time and again by calamities like this, sir. And recently also, it pains me to say that in November, we again had a 4 days of heavy floods, which actually damaged the complete crop of our district and in the adjacent districts of Vijayanagaram also, sir. For this reason, I request the central government, sir, at least in these coastal areas, to take up a special plan in building storage facilities for these farmers, sir. Because in these times, they are totally helpless. If you consider my district, sir, the production is up to 10 lakh metric tons of paddy, sir, every year. But the storage capacity that we have is just a mere 2.5 lakh metric tons. What about the extra production that we have? Even if you wanted to send to other districts, other states, sir, it takes a time of 1 month, 2 months. What happens to this paddy? It just lies on the fields, sir. It just lies in front of their houses to be waiting to be damaged. So the central government needs to come up with a special plan to build up storage facilities, sir, especially for these agricultural production that happens along the coastal areas. And also when it comes to the fishermen community, sir, they all are registered under the insurance scheme. But what happens is they get entangled in this paperwork. When they start the paperwork, it takes minimum of 2 months, 6 months, and up to a process of 1 year also, sir. They don't get the necessary compensation that they are enabled to get. So they have to be an effective mechanism, at least when times like these, when times like the people are facing such pain and horror, we have to take extra responsibility in reaching to them to simplify the measures, to simplify the ways in which we can send them the money to their families, sir, to the bereaved. So the central government should take the responsibility in simplifying the measures in offering the compensation to the families, especially the fishermen community, sir. And also when we see talk about the agriculture, sir, 5 minutes, sir, I come from an area which has been continuously affected by cyclones. 5 minutes, sir. And also when it comes to the businesses also, sir, the companies get affected by the infrastructure.
New member.
They also apply for insurance. But what I suggest the central government to do, sir, at least 50% of the insurance claims, if they can give it immediately, it helps the companies to restart themselves, sir. You know how much loss it is for the companies if they can't be able to run also. So at least from the insurance companies, if the central government takes the responsibility of offering them 50% of the insurance in the immediate time, then they can at least start their activity at the earliest, sir. And also what pinches me time and again is that we are mentioning all these activities as natural disasters, sir. But what we have to keep in mind is that it is some way, indirectly, it is like a man-made disaster only. Why? Because the Lakshadweep, calamity has happened with the Ochki cyclone, it is because of the warming of the seas. It is with the global warming, which has been the doings of the human itself. So by terming it as a natural disaster, we are resisting ourselves to look into the preventive measures which needs to be taken on behalf of human beings itself. So which is why, instead of looking at the remedial measures, we also need to look at the preventive measures also and how to effectively counter these kind of global climate changes also, sir. And for that, one suggestion that I have coming from a coastal place is that if you do a lot of afforestation in the coastal area, sir, it actually protects the coastal community. It actually counters the global climate change that we have. So there are some innovative and simple creative ideas that we can do in countering. It might look like a very big cyclone for us, but small steps can be done today to effectively counter it in the future, sir. So the central government should sit down with all the related departments in terms of agriculture, in terms of businesses, industry and commerce, and they need to chart down a proper plan, sir, when it comes to the natural calamities. Just by having one discussion whenever a calamity has happened and just by sending some amount to that respective state will not help in the future, sir. It is time that we all sit down together and chart a proper plan in countering these kind of natural calamities in the future, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.